The Private Prayers of Lancelot Andrewes. I first got a copy of this when I was a teenager. I think I was about 13 or 14 years old, and the Methodist minister at the time, the Reverend H.V. Briggs, gave me a copy of it. And at the time, it just seemed really strange to me. I liked it, and I was trying to use it, but it was a pattern of prayer that was really alien to me. Lancelot Andrewes was from the 16th century and became a bishop of Winchester, I think. This was like a little private book of devotion that he used morning and evening and then each day of the week. And what he worked out was a little pattern of his own personal prayer times, wrote down and developed his own personal prayers that he could use in the morning, in the evening, and then different ones for each day of the week, prayers to help him prepare himself for taking Holy Communion. It wasn't ever really intended to be published or anything like that, but it was what he had as his personal little journal book for prayer, and then it's now available. It's his little patterns for prayer that he'd worked out to help him. So there's a morning prayer, evening prayer, there's a Sunday set of them, how to begin the week, and what you get in them is this deep set of prayers that are full of the glory and grandeur and wonder of the living God. There's lots of this attempting to impress upon his heart and mind the sheer infinite wonder and glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. A tremendous sense of personal need for this living God. There's lots of confession of sin. There's lots of calling out for help and mercy to be kept free from sin. Lots of it, in a way, is taking what we find in the Lord's Prayer and expanding it out. There's particularly valuable things to help us prepare for Holy Communion. There's a really thorough kind of confession of sin that's provided. A really thorough confession of sin before Holy Communion. And it goes in sections about not giving his whole heart and mind to this wonderful living God, how he's used his time, his possessions, how he's not been as generous as he should, not loved others, how his mind has wandered, his imagination has wandered, he's given into indulging at least the thoughts of deceitful desires, and so on. Powerful. Particularly if you take time over it. You can't rush through. It's only a little book. You could, in a way, I suppose, sit down and just read the whole book in a couple of hours. But it's not like that. What you need to do is just sit and chew on these prayers. Have time, because, for one, his language, you know, it's not the simplest language. He has quite a big vocabulary. So there's that to deal with. But secondly, it's deep stuff. It's profound stuff. It's searching stuff. I'll just give a little flavor and then that'll do. But in his evening prayer, it's not just a meditation on the day, but on life as a whole, and that life itself moves towards you become old and into the evening of life, and how we are needing to depend on the Lord. And when our strength has gone at the end of the day, we're tired, we don't have the energy for anything. Life's like that. It leaves us weaker, and as we get into old age, we need the strength of the Lord more and more. So listen to this. The day is gone, and I give you thanks, Lord. Evening's at hand, furnish it with brightness. As day has its evening, so also has life. The evening of life is age, and age has overtaken me, so furnish it with brightness. Don't cast me away in the time of old age. Don't forsake me when my strength fails me. Even to my old age, be you the one who carries me. Make me, bear me, deliver me. Isaiah 46:4. Abide with me, Lord, for it's toward evening, and the day is far spent of this fretful life. Let your strength be made perfect in my weakness. And so it goes on, this deep meditation that then turns into a time of confession. He always has these times of confession. He usually has a time of focusing on the Lord and lifting up his vision to our Father in heaven and our place standing before him. Then it usually goes into a time of confession and then commendation, committing himself into the keeping of the Lord. For this evening, deliver me from the terror by night, a pestilence that walks in darkness. Psalm 91:6. Supply me with healthy sleep, and to pass through this night without fear. O keeper of Israel, who neither slumberest nor sleepest. Guard me this night from all evil. Guard my soul, O Lord. Visit me with the visitation of thine own. Reveal to me wisdom in the visions of the night. Not because I am worthy, I am not worthy, loving Lord, but let my sleep be to me a breathing time from toil, as also from sin. O Lord, don't let in my dreams I imagine anything that may anger you or that may defile me. I recommend it if you can find it. You can get it online for free, but if you can get a paper copy, it's often easier to use. But try it for a few weeks, praying along with Lancelot Andrewes with these private devotions. It'll deepen and enrich your own prayer life in whatever patterns you normally use.